In one of my last videos, I explained to you that what is the definition of the word marketing. And now the next step, which I would want to help you with, is in understanding that what exactly are needs, wants, and demands. Now, these are three terms which a marketing student would have heard often during his or her classroom or would have read in his or her book. And usually we as students use these three terms interchangeably. However, that is not acceptable and that is grossly incorrect. Therefore, in this video, I'll be explaining you with an example that what exactly is the difference between needs, wants, and demands, and what you need to know about each of these three. Hi, I am Darpan Saxena, an MBA graduate from IIM Udaipur, and let's get on with the video. So I'll help you understand needs, wants, and demand, which are these three important terms in the field of marketing. I'll help you understand this with one example. And for this example, I will have to share with you a story, because that story in itself is the example, and from that you'll clearly understand that what exactly are these three. So here is that story. And by the way, it's not a story, it's the reality of my life. So here it is. So when I was an engineering student, when I had completed my engineering, I knew that, okay, since my engineering college was a very average college, I had to do something which should help me fulfill my need of self-esteem. Because if I'm from an average undergraduate college, I need to do something extra for me to get the kind of job, for me to get the kind of outcome which I want for myself. And that was my need for self-esteem. Now, for me to fulfill this need for my self-esteem, so that I can feel that yes, I have achieved after studying for so many years, I had a few options in front of me. The first option was that I could go for a job. I could work in my job for a few years and I could keep on rising up the hierarchy, after which at a stage I might start to feel that yes, now I earn enough, or now that I have a certain position, so that I can feel that yes, now I have that self-esteem. So that was one of the options. Apart from that, the other options which I had was that I could do an M.Tech, I could do an MBA, or I could go outside, I could go abroad, and I could do MS. Now I had these four options. However, out of these four options, I wanted to do MBA. And when I started to study for MBA, I realized that, okay, if I have to do MBA, the best B schools which I should aim for are the IIMs. And from there, I tried to understand that, okay, IIMs have around 5,000 to 6,000 seats. And for those 5,000 to 6,000 seats, the demand is 2.5 lakhs almost, because there are almost 2 to 2.5 lakh students or aspirants which appear for the CAT exam. So from this example, if you've heard me closely, I used all of those three words: needs, wants, and demand. Now here is what each of these three words are. So in the example, I said that I had a need for a higher self-esteem. Now from here, what you will be able to understand is that a need is basically a deprivation of something. If I am deprived of something, then I will have a need for that. And because the college from which I pursued my engineering, in my eyes, it was an average college. Therefore, I was feeling this need for self-esteem, because that college or the outcomes which I had from there was not able to fulfill my self-esteem needs. So that is needs. That needs means that there is a deprivation of something. Now for you to understand needs, for you as a marketing student to understand needs, you must study the Maslow's hierarchy of needs. Now Maslow's hierarchy of needs is a triangular diagram which beautifully explains that what exactly are the most important needs for a human being and what is the hierarchy of these needs. And if you have understood that hierarchy, then you would be able to understand that, okay, which needs should you as a marketer tap into. So that was about needs. Then the second thing in my example, what I explained was that I said that out of all the four options which I had in front of me, which was a job, MBA, MTech, and MS, I wanted to do an MBA. I wanted to do an MBA to help me solve my need for a higher self-esteem. So what exactly is want? Want means that when I have a need for something, and if I'm able to exactly point out that with what solution will I solve that need, then that particular solution is a want. So want is when I am able to directly identify that what product or service is going to solve the need for the customer. And here in this example, MBA was that exact thing which I had finalized that, okay, if I do an MBA, then I'm sure that my self-esteem would improve. Therefore, I had a want for MBA. For someone else, the same thing, the same need, it could have been fulfilled with a job. Or for someone else, the same need of a higher self-esteem could have been fulfilled by an MTech or a MS abroad. Therefore, what you need to understand is that the same need can be fulfilled, or the human can want different things to fulfill the same need. I hope you've understood it well from this example. And now the third thing which I'll be explaining to you is the word demand. And for that, in my example, I explained it like this, that I said that while the IIMs had some 5,000 to 6,000 seats, the demand for these seats was almost 2 to 2.5 lakh, because the students who were appearing for the exam for these IIMs were 2 to 2.5 lakh aspirants. Which means what? Which means that demand is when I have identified the solution, the want for my need, I have already identified that, and I also have the ability to purchase that particular solution. Which means what? That all the 2.5 lakh aspirants who are appearing for the CAT exam, they have the ability that if they are able to crack an IIM, or if they are able to crack any B school, then they will be able to pay the fees for that, and they will be able to take the admission over there. Which means what? Which means that these 2.5 lakhs are those students who have the ability to pay for the solution which they have identified. From here, what you will be able to also identify is that while I might have identified that, okay, my self-esteem problem will get solved from an MBA, but I might not have the financial ability, or I might not have the ability to crack an IIM exam and to enter a good B school. Therefore, not everyone who wants to do an MBA will actually go ahead and do an MBA. Only the ones who have the ability to pay. In the terms of marketing, it's about the ability to pay. It's about the ability of access. That only those who have the access, or those who have the ability to pay, will be able to have it as a demand. Only those will be the part of the demand for that product. Therefore, from this example, I hope you have understood that what exactly are these three. That a need is when there is a lack or a deprivation of something. A want is when I have uniquely identified that what is it which is going to solve that need, which is going to fulfill that lack which I have. And while I may want something, only when I have the ability to pay for it, and only when I have the access to that solution, only then I am a part of the demand for that. So from here, I hope you've completely understood it, and now you will no longer use these three terms interchangeably. I'll see you in the next video, wherein I'll be explaining you some more interesting marketing concepts. Thank you so much. Goodbye.